Hello students, welcome to Wisdom Academy. I am Nasreen and today we will be seeing hybridization of carbon. So we have already heard about sp3, sp2, sp carbons are different types of carbon. So this classification is based on the hybridization. Now what is hybridization is, we have two atoms. Now these two atoms will intermix with each other and forms a new molecule, okay. So this two atomic orbitals will intermix and form a new orbital called hybrid orbital. That process of producing a new orbital is called hybridization. So for elements we have atomic or molecular orbital, but it comes to compounds, it should undergo hybridization to produce a new orbital for the compound. So I have taken all the three hybridized state of carbon like sp3, sp2 and sp with one example. Now we will see how this hybridization takes place and what are things you need to remember in this. So first, if you take carbon, first we will take sp3. Example which I have taken is methane, in which carbon is bonded with 4 hydrogen. So we all know in sp3 carbon valence is 4, all the 4 will be single bond. In sp3 hybridization, all the 4 bond is single bond. So if it's carbon, electronic configuration is 1s2, 2s2 and 2p2. Now this ground state is, I have written in a orbital diagram. So it is 1s2, 2s2, 2p2. Now it is in ground state. So in order to react with other elements, it has to go to the excited state. In excited state only, atomic orbitals react with each other or mix with each other. So in excited state, it is 1s2, 2s1, 2p3, because carbon valence is 4. We have only 2 unpaired electron, but we need 4 unpaired electron to get bond with hydrogen. Okay, so this form covalent bond. You all know for covalent bond, each element should have at least 1 unpaired electron, but we have only 2 unpaired electron. In order to get 4 unpaired electron, this 2s electrons also would get unpaired. So 1 2 3 4, we have 4 unpaired electron. Now we have 4 unpaired carbon electron and we have 4 hydrogens with 1 electron. We all know hydrogens have only 1 electrons in the valence state. So it is here we have one hydrogen. So 3 hydrogen here and 1 hydrogen here. So totally we have 4 hydrogen with 4 unpaired electrons of carbon. So this is sp3 hybridization. How we got the name sp3 is, we have to see where are this hybridization of taking place, that is where are the carbon and the hydrogen orbitals have got mixed up. So here this x represents hydrogen electron, so sp3, so that's how we got the hybridization sp3. So I have taken a simple molecule of methane. You can go for ethane, propane, any sp3 carbon, okay. But if you go for sp2, if sp2 minimum we need 2 carbons because it involves double bond. So for double bond we need minimum of 2 carbons. So we have carbon 1, carbon 2, same as electronic configuration, ground state, everything is same. But we go to excited state, again we have 4 unpaired electron, but with each carbon you have 2 hydrogen. So I have written 2 hydrogen. But carbon has 2 bond. Here carbon has only, like if you take ethane in sp3, carbon have only 1 bond. But in sp2, carbon have 2 bond. The first bond which is formed is called sigma bond, which is very strong in nature. The second bond which is formed over the sigma bond is called pi bond. So this is how double bond is formed. Initially you need to fill the number of hydrogens and then you have to go for sigma bond, then you have to move on to number of pi bond, okay. So then we have sp hybridization, carbon have triple bond. So carbon 1 excited state, carbon 2 excited state, this is hydrogen, and the first bond formed between carbon is sigma, second bond is pi, third bond is also pi. So second and third bond which is formed over the sigma bond is called pi bond. So basically sigma bond is very strong bond compared to the pi bond. So this is the hybridization. So sp3, sp2 and sp. Now we go for shapes. Like shape for sp3, if it's carbon, this is called tetrahedral shape. It looks like somewhat similar to fan, but the wings will be on the plane, but here the wings will be like little below the plane. It's like below the plane, okay. So this 3 will be joined. So the above one will be above the carbon, which will also join with other hydrogen. This type of shape is called tetrahedral shape. So generally, why it is called tetrahedral is it has four face. Below we have a triangle. So triangle we have three face. Like if this is a, this is carbon. So 1, 2, we have three faces, and side also we have three face. Okay, so totally it has four face. 1, 2, 3 on the top and bottom we have one face. So totally it has four faces. Okay, so it is called tetrahedral. Then comes sp2. Each carbon has trigonal. It is triangle, right? So it is trigonal planar shape. So sp2 is trigonal planar, whereas sp is linear. So linear means it has no deviations from the plane. So it is linear on the plane. So it is called linear shape. So for sp3 it is tetrahedral, for sp2 it is trigonal planar, and for sp it is linear. And this shape is same for all the hybridized carbon. So this is for sp3, sp2 and sp. Now we will come to the bond strength. So whenever you have a single bond, we can easily rotate, because single bond we have only one connection between two carbons, so you can easily rotate, and it's quite weak also. But when we have double bond, the strength is very more higher than the single bond. So twisting a single bond, double bond, is quite difficult. But when we have a triple bond, you cannot do anything, because we have three bonds. So the force of attraction between two bond is very high. So the force of attraction, the bond of single bond is very weak, then double bond, then triple bond. Triple bond compounds are very strong in nature. So these are the bond characteristics of hybridized carbon. So we have seen how to do hybridization, how we will get the hybridization state of carbon, what are the shapes and what is the bond strength. So these are things we have seen in the session. Thank you.